Hello everyone, welcome back to the session. Before going to our main topic, please think about these questions. What happens if we don't eat food for many days? What would happen if we eat same kind of food for many days? What happens, children? If we eat same kind of food for many days, we get only a few kind of food components only. That means you already learned what are the food components in 6th and 7th class. Carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals, fats. Those are all the food components. If we eat same kind of food for many days means we get only a few food components only. So in this lesson, we are going to see that if any food component is not present in our food, that means the food which is taken by us is not contains all varieties of food components, that leads to some diseases. That is we are going to see now. Okay, our topic is malnutrition and vitamin deficiency diseases. Okay, in this lesson the learner going to learn that identifies that which is good food, explains the symptoms of deficiencies, diseases of vitamins, differentiates between kwashiorkor and marasmus, gives reason why some children has swollen abdomen, dry skin and fluffy face, applies knowledge in their daily life by taking vitamin rich food, gives suggestions to their neighbors based on the symptoms of deficiency diseases they have and shows the appropriate remedies to them. Okay, so children, what we have to do to avoid different diseases, we have to eat different kinds of fruits, vegetables and the food components which we already learned, that carbohydrates, proteins, fats, those are all should be present in the food which we are taking. Okay, here this is the pie chart which is showing the food components which we should take. See, the most of the pie chart is covering, that is 50% of our food should contain carbohydrates and the fresh fruits and vegetables. Okay, generally every day we eat rice or carbohydrates related food items like chapati, dosa, idli. Those are all comes under carbohydrates. Fresh fruits and vegetables contains vitamins, minerals, like that. Next, meat, fish, eggs, beans. These are all contains proteins. And fatty acids and sugars, which we are eating curd, oil. Those are all gives us fats and sugars. Dairy products like milk, curd gives us carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals also. Okay, we should our food should contain all these items. Okay, actually what is happening in the world, 2/3 of world population is affected by food related diseases. Especially some of them are suffering by consuming high calorific food. Most of them are facing various diseases due to lack of balanced diet. Lack of balanced diet means the food they are taking is not containing the food components. Okay, let us see what is a lack of balanced diet. That is malnutrition. Malnutrition means eating a food that does not have one or more than one nutrients in required amount is known as malnutrition. One or more than one. That food may not contain required amounts of proteins. That food may not contain proteins and fats also. That type of food is called as malnutritious food. Okay. What are the reasons for this malnutrition? Poor health, willful starvation. Some people are doing fastings like that. So they wantedly do not take the food. Lack of awareness of nutritional habits, socio-economic factors. These are all the reasons for malnutrition. How many types are there in malnutrition? Here you are observing three types: protein malnutrition, calorie malnutrition, protein calorie malnutrition. First, what is protein malnutrition? Protein malnutrition means the food which we are taking does not contain protein food. That means we are not eating the proteins. Then the person gets protein malnutrition. Second one, calorie malnutrition. Calorie means the food does not contains calorie rich food. So if that food is consumed by the person, that person can get calorie malnutrition. What about protein calorie malnutrition? In this type of case, proteins and calories both are absent in the food taken by the person. So that person get protein calorie malnutritious disease. Okay. Now let us see the examples for these cases. First one is Kwashiorkor disease. How this Kwashiorkor disease occur means the children, especially malnutritious diseases symptoms will appear especially in children. Okay, if the elder ones do not take the food, balanced diet for days, they don't show any symptoms. If they take the balanced diet after a few days, they can recover. But the children, in case of children, they show some symptoms, malnutritious symptoms, if they do not given sufficient nutritious diet. Okay, see this case, Kwashiorkor disease case. This is the disease caused by the protein deficiency. What are the symptoms of this disease? Water accumulation in the intercellular spaces. That means in between cells, water accumulates here. That obviously that leads to the swollen of the body. Obviously the body becomes swell. Poor muscle development. Swollen legs. Fluffy face. Difficult to eat. See in this image you can easily observe the fluffy face, swollen stomach or abdomen, diarrhea. Diarrhea means frequently vomiting, motions like that condition will seem. Dry skin. These are all the symptoms of the Kwashiorkor disease, which is caused due to the protein deficiency. So what we have to do here, the children who is suffering with the Kwashiorkor disease, we have to keep the protein rich food to the children. Then children will cure or get out of that disease. The second one is marasmus. This marasmus is caused due to both the protein and calorie deficiency. How this marasmus disease situation occurs or happens means, if the mother gets immediate second pregnancy or repeated childbirth, the first child she could not give the mother milk to the first child, so that a child can leads to this, gets this disease. So what are the symptoms of this marasmus? Lean and weak. See, observe the image of the kid here. He has a prominent bones. We can count the bones of this boy. So that much lean, less developed muscles, dry skin, diarrhea. These are the symptoms of the children who are suffering with marasmus disease. What about excess eating? We have seen two cases. In that two cases, one is suffered with the protein deficiency, another one is suffered with both the protein and calorie deficiency food. Here, some persons or some children eating excess. They eat always eat excess food. So what about them? What happens to them? That leads to obesity. Obesity is accumulation of excessive body fat having a negative effect on health. So overeating or excess of calories intake leads to obesity. This obesity in future, this obese children will be target to many diseases because of that fat deposition in the blood vessels that leads to heart problems, diabetes problems, cardiovascular. Cardiovascular means that blood vessels will be filled with this fatty bodies, renal problems, gallbladder problems. These are all the problems will occur to the obese children. So we should not give the children high calorie food or junk food also. Okay. So another one type of deficiency diseases are vitamin deficiency diseases. Actually, we have seen kwashiorkor, marasmus. Those are the deficiency diseases of protein and carbohydrates. Here, those are macronutrients required for us. Vitamins are micronutrients. We require the vitamins in very less quantity. But we require in less quantity, but they should compulsory present in our food. Without them, we may get some diseases. Okay, how we are getting these vitamins? What are the sources of vitamins? Means diet. Generally, we are getting these vitamins through our food. Second one is bacteria present in our gut or alimentary canal. In our digestive tract, there are some bacteria present. That bacteria synthesizes some kinds of vitamins. Okay, so vitamins are of two types. First one is water soluble vitamin and the second one is fat soluble vitamins. Water soluble vitamins are B complex vitamins and vitamin C. Fat soluble vitamins are A, D, E, K. These are the fat soluble vitamins. Okay. Now we will see one by one. If food we take doesn't contain vitamins in right proportion, it can lead to vitamin deficiency disorders. Now we will see one by one the deficiency disorders of vitamins. The first one is thiamine, that is B1. We have seen that B-complex. B-complex means in the B there are some other vitamins, B1, B2, B3, B6, B12, like that. So that is why we are calling it as B-complex. First, in B complex, first vitamin is B1, that is the chemical name of B1 is thiamine. If our food does not contain thiamine, we may get the disease beriberi. What are the symptoms of this beriberi? Beriberi symptoms are vomiting, fits, loss of appetite, difficulty in breathing, paralysis. These are all the symptoms. If you observe the picture, the person is suffering with the beriberi disease. He paralyzed. He can't able to walk on his own. Loss of appetite means the person do not feel of hunger. They don't have hunger feeling. Okay. Then what are the remedies? How can we how can we get rid of this disease? Means the person should eat cereals. Food sources of vitamin B1 are cereals, oil seeds, vegetables, milk, meat, fish, eggs, etc. Okay. And the second one disease of B complex is riboflavin, that is B2 vitamin. The deficiency disease is glossitis. If the person the food which is taken by does not contain the riboflavin, that person can get glossitis disease. He may suffer with mouth cracks at corners. I think you all observed the mouth cracks. Some people are suffering with the mouth cracks at their corners. Red and sore tongue, photophobia, scaly skin. Here, photophobia means they are not able to see the light, sunlight. Food sources: milk, eggs, liver, kidney, green leafy vegetable. These are the sources of B2 vitamin. So we should eat these food sources. So then we should not get that glossitis disease. Third one is niacin B3, that is pellagra. The chemical name of B3 is niacin. The deficiency disease we get is pellagra. What are the symptoms of the disease pellagra? Dermatitis, dementia, diarrhea. We commonly call this disease as pellagra disease is commonly called as 3D disease. 3D. Why we are calling it as 3D? In dermatitis D, dementia D, diarrhea D. Dermatitis means skin diseases. Dementia means loss of memory. Diarrhea means vomiting, motions like that situation. This is 3D disease. Scaly skin means the persons are like you are observing here in the picture. Scaly skin. Okay. And the sources of vitamin B3 are kidney, liver, meat, egg, fish, oil seeds. These are all the sources of vitamin B3. So children, don't forget to eat all these food items. Okay. And vitamin B6, that is pyridoxine. The chemical name of B6 is pyridoxine. If the deficiency disease of this pyridoxine is anemia. Symptoms are hyperirritability, nausea, vomitings, fits. If you are observing this picture, is the white skin person as having anemia. The blood levels of them is very less. Hemoglobin percentage is very less in them. So to improve our blood quality, we have to eat cereals, oil seeds, vegetables, milk, meat, fish, eggs, liver of different animals like goat, sheep, like that. Okay. So these are the sources of vitamin B6. And next one vitamin is cyanocobalamin, that is B12. The deficiency disease is pernicious anemia. Symptoms of this disease is lean and weak, less appetite. Person looks very lean. They don't have the feeling of hunger. And this bacteria is synthesized by, sorry, this vitamin is synthesized by bacteria present in our intestines. Okay. The source of vitamin B12 is bacteria synthesizes in our intestines. Okay. And next one vitamin is folic acid. The deficiency disease is anemia. Folic acid is also a part of B complex. Okay. The symptoms of this anemia are diarrhea, loss of leukocytes, problems related to mucus in the intestines. And how can we get rid of this disease? How can we avoid this disease? We have to eat fresh fruits and vegetables, milk, meat, eggs. Then we can recover from anemia. Okay. And another one, B complex vitamin is pantothenic acid. The deficiency disease is burning feet. Symptoms are walking problems and sprain. The food sources rich food sources of pantothenic acids are sweet potato and nuts. All dry fruits contains this pantothenic acid. So if a person is suffering with burning feet, they should eat these kind of food items. He can easily recover from that disease. Okay. And a last one, B vitamin that is biotin. The deficiency disease is nerve disorder. The symptoms of this disease are fatigue. Fatigue means a physical, that may be physical or mental fatigue. Person continuously doing some kind of work, they easily get nervous or gets fatigue. mental depression, muscle pains. These are the symptoms of the nerves disorder. The sources are pulses, nuts, vegetables, liver, milk, kidneys of animals are the sources of biotin, vitamin. So these are the very important B complex vitamins we have seen up to yet. Now I am moving to another one interesting vitamin and very very useful vitamin, ascorbic acid, that is vitamin C. If we don't have C vitamin in our body, we may get scurvy disease. What is scurvy? Symptoms of this disease are delay in healing of wounds. It takes much time to healing of wounds in our body. Fractures in bone. Easily our bones will break. So what we have to do to get ourselves strong, or what we have to eat to strengthen our body with the C vitamin? Citrus family fruits like orange, citron, lemon. These are all helps us in giving C vitamin. And also guava. Those are all very helpful for us. Okay. Next one vitamin is vitamin A. Vitamin A, the chemical name is retinol. What are the deficiency disease the person get? The first one picture you are observing is xerophthalmia. Xerophthalmia means dry eyes. The person may get dry eyes, obviously they can't able to see. The second one is cornea failure. This is the image after the surgery. Cornea failure, the person who is suffering with cornea failure, the arrangement of cornea here happened. And some other diseases of vitamin A are night blindness and scaly skin also. Okay, some persons can't able to see in the evenings, in the dark, at night times. So that is because of vitamin A. That persons could not able to see in the night means their rod cells are not working properly. Rod cells works properly then when the person contain good amounts of vitamin A. So how to improve our vitamin A quantity and quality means we have to take leafy vegetables, carrot, tomato, pumpkin, papaya, mango, meat, fish, liver, eggs. Finally, if we are not able to eat some of them, we can take the pills of shark liver and cod liver oil pills. These are pills available in the medical stores. These oil pills are prepared from the fishes, sharks and cod fishes. Okay, they extract the oil from the liver of these fishes and makes as the pills. This shark liver, cod liver oil pills contains rich amounts of vitamin A and also vitamin D too. Okay. And now I am moving to vitamin D. Vitamin D, sun rays stimulates the formation of vitamin D from the subcutaneous fat. Generally, our elder says that you have to stay in sunlight in the morning to get vitamin D. What happens at that time is that sun rays transform the cholesterol which we have in our body, cholesterol into calciferol. Calciferol means vitamin D. So that is why he is saying that sun rays stimulates the formation of vitamin D from the subcutaneous fat. This is also available in liver, eggs, butter, cod liver and shark liver oils are the sources of vitamin D. What happens if vitamin D is not sufficient in our body? Improper formation of bones in children, especially delayed dentition, weak bones, knock knees, swollen wrists are the symptoms of disease rickets. Rickets is the disease caused by vitamin D deficiency. Generally, it is observed in children. See, these are the children have the disease rickets. First one kid has a knock knee. The both knees are actually here together. And the third child has bow legs. See, observe the legs shape is in bow. So bow legs, knock knee is observed in Rickets disease. See, the normal anatomy of bone is this, and this is the Rickets diseased person's bone anatomy. See, the fractures or cracks in the bones. The bones are very weak in this case. So we should eat rich D vitamin foods. Then only our bones will strong. Okay. Delayed some in children's some children do not get the teeth fast. So because of that D vitamin deficiency only. So we should give the D vitamin rich food items to the kid. And the next vitamin is tocopherol, that is vitamin E. If we do not eating the vitamin E rich foods, that person get fertility disorders. Fertility disorder means sterility in males. They can't able to produce next generation. The abortions in females, generally they can't able to carry the baby in their womb. These are the fertility disorders caused by vitamin E deficiency. Okay, where they are available, where this vitamin E available more means all varieties, all kinds of oils. So we should take different varieties of oils. Okay, sunflower, mustard, sesame, coconut, different types of oils contains this vitamin E. And next, another one vitamin, that is vitamin K. The chemical name of it is phylloquinone. This vitamin deficiency leads to delay in blood clotting and over bleeding when we get wounds. Okay, so how can we overcome this problem? By eating leafy vegetables, and also eggs, liver, meat, milk helps us to overcome this disease or problem. Okay, and now I am moving to evaluation. Up to yet we have seen different varieties of vitamin deficiency diseases and the malnutritious diseases. Now everyone should write the answers for these questions and send these answers to your teachers. Name the vitamin which is also called as sunshine vitamin. That means sunshine vitamin means we are getting this vitamin through sun. And the sun, sun here giving us vitamin D indirectly. Write the detailed description on malnutritious diseases. If a person is suffering from burning feet, what food items do you suggest him to overcome that problem? What are the water soluble vitamins? What happens if we take excess calorific food? How kwashiorkor is different from the disease marasmus? Name the vitamin which is the reason for fractures in bones and low healing capacity. Write the symptoms of the disease caused by thiamine. Okay. Thanks for watching. This is Pavitra, SA Bioscience from Gattipalli. If you want more updates, please subscribe my channel. Then you will get more videos on different classes from 6th to 10th. Okay.